really quick, where's your, this lady, young lady? When I saw you, there was a, I'm just going to prophesy to a couple people first, and then we're going to get going, but I just want to stir this. Come here. There's something on you that has been on you for the last 3.5 years that is amplified. This is, there's a spirit of Deborah on you. Okay, it's not just on your cousins and your brothers and everybody else. There is a preaching anointing on you that will be activated, and there's a sensitivity that God is doing. He's tuning your ears to hear what I believe the Spirit of the Lord is saying to your generation. And the dreams that you had, I believe 3.5 years ago, God began to give you sequences of dreams, and you're about ready to come into some of those things. God is wanting you to be a trailblazer in this season. And as you do that, you've encountered some sort of hiccups, okay? But the Lord says, I am able in 2017 to remove the hiccups in your life, and you're about ready to have your forehead stronger than that which has tried to come against you. And what has been hard simply now will become easy. It's almost as the last 1.5 years, you've been like, it's almost like the little red engine that said, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can. And you've been carrying this burden, but I say to you that there is a turning point, because now you have hit the summit, says the Spirit of grace, and now what you have carried to the top now will begin to push you all the way down. And it's a season. What has been difficult now shall become easy, and you shall see God work in and out of every difficult situation. But he says everything that I showed you in the dream will begin to blossom and will begin to unfold before your very eyes, says the Lord. There is an anointing that breaks yokes and removes burdens on you. You shall see people restored. You have a burden for the lost. You have a burden for the afflicted. You have a burden for those that are battered and bruised and out of the way. Those that are even trafficking. The Lord says, I'll give you a heart that is bigger, and I will enlarge the capacity of thy heart in this season. The prayers of your heart, the intercessions you have prayed over the last 3.5 years, the Lord says, it's been like fertilizer. And I will begin to fertilize. I will begin to fertilize the ground that I have had you on. And you will begin to see that I will remove walls. And if there is a wall, even in this season, I will cause you to leap over a wall and go through some troops in this season, because there's a tenacity and a courage on the inside of you that is stronger than any enemy, says the Spirit of grace. This is your season of promotion. Don't look back, but watch by the month of April and May things to be unfold and things to be clear. I remove the fog and that which has been obscure. This is your season, says the Lord, where I begin to do something great in you. Put your hands together, somebody. Amen. If you don't have the Holy Ghost, just stand up. If you want the Holy Ghost, stand up. Come on. If you got the Holy, you want the Holy Ghost? I'm telling you, stand up. Come quickly, real quick. Quickly come. What time is it? Did I preach? Are you doing all right? Are we doing all right?
Amen. En el nombre de Jesús. Ah, sígale a su nombre. Glorita, gloriata. Gordita, gordia.
All of you need the Holy Ghost? All of you? Were you the drummer? I thought nobody can drum like that unless you have the Holy Ghost. Can you imagine now you having the Holy Ghost? Make room for everybody. Make room for everybody. Come over here real quick. I think there's 2 or 3 more, man. Just come on up. You need the Holy Ghost. Come on. I believe there's 2 people here need to get saved too. I'm just pushing. The Holy Spirit. How you know is you don't want to come. You want to come. Listen, you want to come, but you're like, nah, man. Nah, man. That's the Holy Ghost. If you need it, if that's you, I would get up and come to the altar and get saved. Is that you? Look at that. One salvation. I believe there's 1 more. Perhaps maybe 2 more. That's all I'm saying. I ain't making nobody do nothing. If that's you, just hey, I surrender. You bow now or later. It doesn't matter to me. I just preach. Say Jesus. Anybody else? Is that you? I knew it. Come right here. Come right here. Come right here. One more. Uno más. Say it in Chinese. Chongqing ma cha. One more. Come. Say Jesus, everybody. Say Jesus. Jesus. Say Jesus. Jesus. Come into my heart.
Come into my heart.
Make me new. I believe that you rose from the dead. And 3 days later, rose from the dead. I receive you in my life. Help me now live this godly life in Jesus' name. Come on, amen and amen. I suppose now you want the Holy Ghost. Huh? Okay, listen up really quick. How you get the Holy Ghost is the same way you got saved. By faith. Okay? My wife and I are going to lay hands on you. Some of you are going to feel something. Some of you may not feel something. Whether you feel something or not feel something has nothing to do with whether or not you received it. Because you receive it by faith. Come on. So when I lay hands on you and I say open up your mouth, you have to take the syllables that God has put in you. And you just release it. Don't do it from your head. You don't speak in tongues from your brain. You speak in tongues from your spirit. So you have to bypass your brain, okay, and let your spirit pray. When you pray in tongues, the Holy Ghost prays. That's what the Bible says, okay? So you open up your mouth and you say, well, I don't know what I'm supposed to say. Whatever syllables come to your mind. There's no right way or wrong way to do it. Then there's going to be, as soon as you do that, there's going to be a little bad guy on this side going, ah, that's not it. And then there's going to be a good guy on this side, and he says, yeah, keep doing it. Keep doing it. That's it. Listen to that one. You need to tell this guy to shut up. And when you leave here, you need to continue to tell him to shut up. For about a week, he's not going to leave you alone. So you got to keep on doing it until he leaves you alone. I'm telling you, this will bring you in to supernatural intervention and power. Yeah. I'm telling you, this is the secret to the prophetic. It's a secret to the miracles. It's a secret to signs and wonders. All of you having the Holy Ghost can now operate in those gifts. And maybe one day I can come back and teach them on how to operate in the prophetic at small levels. So when you go evangelize, listen, I'm not in competition with your pastor. I love your pastor. God is the one who brings increase. You can, right now, there's 17 ways to grow a church, okay? There's 17 ways. All of them are really based on business, not on Acts 2. Hey, praise God, it's just not Acts 2. They're based on business models. It says that you can grow the church without the gifts of the Spirit. That's ludicrous to me. It's the Spirit that draws. It's the Spirit that draws. Amen? So I need you to just pretend you're a spiritual sponge. To just close your eyes. Give me some space. Tell your neighbor, give me a little space. Give me a little space. Some of you need to go forward. Some of you need to come forward. We're going to lay hands on you. Be a sponge. I'm going to lay hands on all of you. And then when I say open up your mouth, you let it rip, okay? Let it rip. Just, I want to hear thunder. 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 Ready? Close your eyes. Lift up your eyes. And don't fall unless the Holy Ghost just trips you up, okay? Then it's not going to hurt. Okay? Don't courtesy fall. I've been doing this 27 years. I don't need a courtesy fall no more. Okay? So if the Holy Ghost makes you fall and he trips you up and picks you up and slams you, praise the Lord. Okay? Meredith, start on that side. Here we go. Father, these people want the Holy Ghost. Let them have it. In the name of Jesus, let them have it. Let them have it. I release the Holy Ghost. I release the Holy Ghost. I release it. I release the Holy Spirit. I release the Holy Ghost. I release it. I release it. I release it. Come here, baby. Come here. Come here. I release the Holy Ghost. Come here, baby. I release the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. I release it. 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 I release the Holy Ghost. There it is. I release it in the name of Jesus. I release the Holy Ghost. Ah, sekere bohoso. Breka. I release the Holy Ghost. I release it. I release it. I release the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. There's some watching by way of live stream right now. The power of God, there's no difference and no distance in spirit. Some of you have been wanting and desiring to be filled with the Holy Ghost, with the evidence of speaking in tongues. Come on, there's no difference or distance. Right now, just touch the screen in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Go through those TV and computers, and I ask that the power and the presence of God that is found and located in this place would be upon that place, and they would speak in tongues. Open up your mouth. Everybody, open up your mouth. Open up your mouth. Let the syllables come out. Regardless of how crazy it may sound. Come on, lift it. Come on, do it. Open up your mouth. You got to say something. There it is. Come on. There it is.
Father, in the name of Jesus, let it go.
Like a river, like a river, like a river, like a river.
Oh, Holy Spirit, we welcome you today.
There's a lady in the purple. There's a lady in the purple, the light purple. Both of you are purple. It's okay, just stay right there. I saw God touching your body. God's touching your body. And he's given you strength. And he's given you stability. And whatever complications you're having at this moment concerning your body, the power of God comes on you right now. I know you're having a baby. Somebody take that baby. The power of God is all over you, mama. Come here really quick. I had a vision of you at 1 o'clock this afternoon, that there would be a lady in light purple that would come and get a healing today. In the name of Jesus. Come on. Come on. Let's speak in tongues, man. Speak in tongues. Speak in tongues. Come on. Let me hear it. For the Lord says, this is the hour where I'm bringing you up and out. This is where I have saved and delivered you, says the Lord. I have brought you out of even family drama. And the Lord says, woman, I have taken many people like yourself from shattered dreams and shattered problems. Oh, when you've seen, it's like shattered glass all over. But the Lord says, I am the artist. I'm the one that can bring together broken pieces and make a sculpture out of it that is beautiful. And the Lord says, daughter, I have taken and will take the broken pieces, the things that were not even your fault, the things that were taken and the things that were defiled, even from the time that you were 13 and 15 and 17. But the Spirit of the Lord says, daughter, it wasn't even your fault. The Lord says, I'm bringing healing. I pour in the oil, I pour in the wine, and I bring healing and a cleansing. For today is a day where you can let it go. You have wrestled too long, too many times, and particularly in the night season. Many don't even know the tears and the fears that you have had, and even broken relationship after broken broken relationship, of broken promises. But the Spirit of the Lord says, today I will raise you up like an Esther, and I will call you to be a queen. And I will tell you 10 years from now, they won't even recognize you from where you are at. I will pluck you up, set you on a firm foundation. This is a new day for you, says the Lord. I breathe upon you a fresh breath of Holy Spirit. Go ahead. Everybody speaking tongues in here.
This is the realm of your grace. I can feel your mighty power.
Where's the lady?
Moving in this place. In the presence.
You're about ready to see the power of God. Come here real quick. The power of God. Just lift your hands. At 1 o'clock p.m., I saw the power of God hitting a lady in light purple. And whatever has afflicted your body, this started over about 3-4 months ago, and there's been something leashed, but I have come to sever by the sword of the Spirit. Don't touch her. The power of God comes on you. Ah! Be set free! Hey! By the power of God! Come on, somebody. I'll look at Malachi, and Malachi, we've done this together so many times, so I'll just go like this and just bring it down. Asthma. If you're battling with asthma of any sort, asthma, I want to pray for you. Or if you have struggles with nose, ear, and throat. Nose, ear, and throat. That you? Come. Asthma? Throat? Throat near? Who's asthma? You can't hear? In the name of Jesus. Come on, man. You ready to hear? You want to hear? I have seen so many deaf ears open. Were you born that way? Okay. Who, asthma, anybody? Asthma? I've just seen asthma heal so off so many times. There's a blood condition being healed right now. Ooh, Jesus. A blood condition. Right now, there's somebody, a female here, that is having problems with your menstrual cycle. You're having problems with your cycle, and it's been ongoing for the last couple of years. I'm telling you tonight, Jesus wants to heal that in the name of Jesus. Come on, throat, ear, in the name of Jesus. Are you ready? The power of God comes to heal today in the name of Jesus. Come on, Malachi, take it up.
He is holy.
You are. healing. You can perfectly hear from that ear. Close that ear. Close this ear. Repeat after me, okay? Jesus. Jesus.
Jesus.
Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
I'm beautiful.
I'm beautiful.
I'm sexy.
You're sexy.
Come on, somebody, put. God just opened up an ear. This lady right here in the sweatshirt. Yeah, step right out in the name of Jesus. It's a new season. The day of tears and fears come to a complete end. You have struck water more times than you know. I got two things to tell you. Isaac was commanded to go up to the highlands and redig his father's wells. Only problem when he did it, it was during famine. And when he did, he sowed in that land in the time of famine. And the Bible says he reaped 100-fold in that year. He was mandated to redig his father's wells. But every time he would dig, he would discover there's water. But every time he struck water, there was Philistines that would take the well and they would put dirt on it. It wasn't that they wanted the well. They just didn't want Isaac to have it. The only thing the Philistines didn't know was that the blessing that was on his father was on him. So it didn't matter where he went, that if he dug for water, he was going to strike water. You have struck water more times than you know to only allow the spirit. There's been the spirit of the Philistine to try to put dirt on it. It's not in this last, it's been like a 7-year cycle. And it's every time you came to striking water, it's almost like it gets stolen or ripped off. That season has come to a complete end in your life. I come to break the cycle of your life. This is a day of God's power. It's a God interfering, and you will see what God purposed in your heart from the get-go. There is no devil in hell that can take what God has promised. It's a new day. Go ahead. There's a new song. There's a dance in your step. God will allow you to shout in this season, and as you shout, God will give you the possessions of your heart. There's a fresh anointing on you, and you will see it comes on you this day. Send the Spirit of grace.
Say it's a season that you have known what it is to fight against and be pushed back. You've gone through and endured that season. But I heard the Lord say it is a shifting of the winds on your behalf. Like the disciples who found themselves in the middle of the lake only to find that the winds and the storms and everything came up. I heard the Lord say the winds of adversity that have blown against you in the last 6 months to even 18 months of your life are now going to become the very winds that cause you to go where you need to be. For I heard the Lord say, get ready for the spirit of success that has seemed to elude you for a season. Wow. You've tasted it. You touched it. You've known. You've heard. The prophecies have been given. People have said. You've heard it over and over. But yet you have failed to reach or obtain. And it wasn't about money, but you knew God created you for wealth. Because you said, God, if you cause my hands to hold it, I won't hold on to it. I'll give it. I'll fund the kingdom. kingdom. I'll fund projects. I'll do what you've called me to do, only to see doors shut on your behalf. I heard the Spirit of the Lord say, the doors that have shut have only been seasons and opportunities because I didn't create you for mediocre, and I didn't create you just to sustain, and I didn't create you to be just in the middle, but I'm causing you to walk through the seasons of adversity and the seasons of calamity. And I hear the Spirit of the Lord say, get ready, son, for I am blowing upon you, and everything that has held you back and kept you from getting where you needed to go now moves behind you, and you will find the ease to get what you need to do. The connections with people that have not returned phone calls will start returning phone calls. The doors you've knocked on and the persistence of where you have stood. This is the hour where favor is your portion, says the Spirit of grace. I release fresh favor, fresh fire, and I declare the life and the power of God and the funds that belong to this man for the sake of the kingdom. What I heard was, you haven't given it all away. You've watched your kids succeed, and you've watched your kids come forth, and you've watched the goodness of God follow the generations. But I heard the Lord say, tell them they didn't give it all away. Your prayers created the platform for another generation to succeed. Your sacrifice has been the very balance and the very place where they have stepped on. But I heard the Lord say, woman of God, in this hour, there are prayers even unuttered to anyone else that you've given to God. And you've said, Lord, I would love to see some things happen just because you're good. And just because I would love to see it. So as an inheritance, as a testimony to my children and my children's children, to my family that I left, to all the ones who said we would never make it, that you would be magnified in the midst of it, not for your gain, but for the sake of what you sacrificed, that you, they would see the goodness of God. I heard the Lord say, those prayers have not been selfish, and those prayers were not in vain, for watch what's about ready to happen in the next year, in the next 2 to 3 years, you will see the fulfillment of dreams, of wishes, of things that you never thought would happen. For God has been so good to you, and you have walked through so many seasons. But I hear the Lord say, it is a season now of payback, and it's a season of recompense. For I will cause every tear that has ever been shed, every hour that you've ever let go, all the stuff you've gone through, I hear the Lord say, as you have been willing to shift with the generations, watch what I'm about ready to do. For I will honor the faith of you, man and woman of God, and cause it to be known throughout the nations of the world, the faith, the sacrifice, the love, and the devotion you have both shared, says the Spirit of the Lord.
Wow, hold on, Lana. To do something tonight, because the prophet in me, I have a right. I see what my gift is. I see the potential and the gifts in people, and then I unwrap them. Okay, but your gift is almost as though it's been at Christmas. It's that gift that has no name on it. And so it gets put there till New Year's, and it's like, hey, whose is it? We don't know. Open it up. That's you. But God's about ready to put a name on it. Yeah. I didn't know why, but within you is prophetic destiny. Yeah. And it's going to be in your womb, and it'll come out through your mouth. There's a prophetic anointing that I'm unwrapping, and you're going to see it like you see paintings, except you're going to see people, and you're going to see their lives, and you're going to begin to see God will give you exactly how you do the paintings. God is going to, I'm going to unwrap that gift and turn it from portrait to words. Your mouth will be the paintbrush. You are frustrated because God says, I'll use that for a season, but I'll use that for training for the rest of her life. You will be painting prophetically in the lives and hearts of people all over the world. Your husband has a heart for evangelism and he's apostolic, but God always lines up an apostolic minister with a prophetic minister. And together, you're a complete package, the apostolic and the prophetic. I'm going to lay hands on you, and that thing is going to be unwrapped. And you're going to begin to see in the spirit, and you're going to begin to paint with words people's lives and give them the spirit of affirmation through the spirit of hope, which is the spirit of the prophetic. And you will do it in your own words, and you're not going to be afraid of opening your mouth and saying some things, because God will back up every word with what you say. Are you ready for this? Stretch out your hand. It's a new day. It's a new hour. God says, I'm going to give you double for your trouble. And this is the day where I come all over you. And anything that has been a burden, anything that has been a blockage, anything that has been like a beaver hut, I remove from your life, from the time you were 12 and 15 and 17. In the name of Jesus, it's a new day. We unwrap this prophetic gift in the name of Jesus. And as a sign, that you will begin to operate in fullness, you will watch that you will be pregnant. You will be pregnant with a baby, and I see a baby boy. And I see it as a sign of what God will do prophetically in your life, like a Hannah. The times you have cried and sighed, I'll give you a Samuel. And he will be a prophetic sign for you and a prophetic declaration for both of your lives. And you will see it manifest and come to pass. In the near future, watch what and see what I do, says the Lord. But I remove whatever is blocking, whatever is hesitant, whatever has come to frustrate you. And this is the hour where God overturns it, says the Spirit of grace. Watch and see what I do, says the Lord. Come on, somebody.
I really believe I heard the Lord as we walked in tonight. Because I thought, Lord, why are we here besides an invitation? I understand that, but why are we here? And I heard this is because your season of famine has come to an end. And it takes a prophet to announce the end of a famine.
Spirit of the raven is broken.
The thing that has come to steal from you, the thing that has come to take from you, the thing that has come to cause lack in your house. I heard the Lord say, the very frustration of Gideon is what became his very deliverance. Only to find by Judges chapter 7 that the man that had a dream of a loaf of bread tumbling into the camp, and then the interpretation was it was none other than the sword of Gideon. The loaf was the sacrifice he had given. This is what I believe the Lord sent us here to say, is that that which has tried to steal from you, the Midianites, the strife that tried to rob from you. Over the last 7 years, you have contended with the spirit of strife, with those that have come to take and steal. They didn't come when you planted, and they didn't come when you were growing. They came every time harvest came, and you thought you hit a breakthrough, only to be pushed back. But there was something about this last year that you said, God, I don't care what comes this way. I'm not moving, I'm not quitting. And I might be treading in a wine press, and I might be treading the grain in the wine press, but I'll keep on pushing. pushing. And I heard the Lord say, you tell them that the famine that tried to come, strife that has tried to rob you, to keep you and to make your voice dormant, even in this region, says the Spirit of the Lord, has been broken and no longer shall affect you or affect your house or affect your people. It will no longer affect your bank account. It will no longer affect your womb. It will no longer affect your dreams. But I hear the Lord say, this is your season of planting. This is your season of breakthrough. I will give you your 300 plus. Watch what I do, for you will turn a city upside down. You'll turn a region upside down. And I will cause your voice to be amplified to the nation, says the Spirit of the Lord. Famine is broken over your house now.
Woo. I don't know what your name is. There's three breakings to a seed. The first breaking is the toughest, because you have to break out of itself. The second breaking, you have to break out of the soil. But the third breaking is when it breaks into fruit. The first two you've gone through, and it was difficult. But you're about ready to step into a season of fruitfulness that you know not of. No weapon formed against you can prosper. Every tongue that would rise up against you, we condemn. This is your promise. This is your heritage. It's a season where God will come and visit you in your dream and your nighttime. And he will give to you specific things of what you're to become and do. And you will carry forth those dreams. Yeah, you will carry forth those dreams. But God says, I never called you to be silent. I never even called you to be in the back. I've called you to be in the forefront. And I will cause you and make you a leader. I'm the one who will make you and take you and make you and bring you to that place that everybody has desired. And the Lord says, there's a season where I will answer. The beginning even of the year, you ask the Lord of a couple things. And you're about ready to see the fruitfulness of those prayers come into complete fruition. This is your season. He removes all of the debris, every obstacle out of your way. In Jesus' name. There's going to be a song sung. Malachi, I'm going to put a demand on your prophetic gift. I want you to sing about the seed unfolding and blossoming. And it's going to come forth and it's going to bring healing. It's going to be a song that will heal and mend. But it'll also be a song that will thrust you into the next season of your life.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I will take you, and I will make you. Then I will break you, so that I can make you again. It's a new season, oh yes, and it is a new hour, says the Lord, that it is your time to rise, and it is your time to flourish, and I will lift the sun up over your head, and it will begin to give you life. And you will find that in my name, that you will receive joy and peace and overwhelming happiness. Oh, my daughter, I bring you new life. Now you can put the old away, for I have made you new, says the Lord.
Come on, let's worship.
Ooh,
everybody, lift up holy hands.
How
worship you, Lord, I will worship you.
don't know what your name is. Don't tell me it's Stephanie, though. Don't tell me that. I just saw a crown on you. I saw a crown on you, and I say to you, let no man steal your crown. As I saw you, I saw Psalms 23. He's going to become literally your shepherd, leading you beside still water. You're going to see in this next season the table placed right in the midst of every single one of your enemies. And you're going to find out that he's got oil for you, and he's got a cup that runneth over. It's your season to experience oil. It'll be smothered. It'll be rubbed into you. At times you will even smell it supernaturally, just to allow, God's just allowing you to know supernaturally that I'm in the middle of your situation. And God says, I'm going to cause your cup, come on, to spill over. There's some finances that have been stripped and ripped off from you. I don't even know how or where, but you're about ready to see a turnaround in that in this next 2017. God is the recovery. He is the stand-up and the recovery of your life. And because you're a worshiper, and because you understand the power of worship, it's almost been that attractive magnetic force that is bringing this. You're about ready to experience. 2015 was not necessarily the greatest. 2016 was a little better, but 2017, you're going to step totally radically out, and God brings you to the highlands of the tabletops, and he's going to cause you to eat, and he's going to cause you to drink, come on, of the still waters. And that which was taken, that which was stolen, I hear the Lord say, tell her I'll give her double for all her trouble. I'll give you double for your trouble in 2017. For you will see victory at every side. It's a new day of my power. It's a new day of my grace. It's a new day where I smother you with my goodness. There are tons of surprises coming your way, says the Lord. You will see it, says the Spirit of God's grace. Oh yeah.
I will worship.
There's people here that has been having problems with their digestive system, okay? I don't know if it's acid reflux. I just know it's the digestive system here. But I don't know if, listen, I've seen God heal ulcers. I've seen God heal all kinds of intestinal problems. That's you. I want to pray with you before we go tonight, okay? Is that acid reflux? That's what I thought. Yeah. Acid reflux, digestive system. In the name of Jesus, come on, who will believe with me? Martin, it's a new season for you, man. It's like the last 3.5, 4, 5 years, you've been just practicing. No, I'm serious. I see open doors for you. If open doors... I've seen open doors. I see at least 6 or 7 doors in this next coming years that will be open because people want to hear what you have to say. Okay? And God is amplifying and mingling. I'm going to pray for you guys in a minute, okay? I'm just prophesying. And God is mingling with fire. And it's not just words that are going to come from other CDs and books. All that is great. That's where we start. But you're about ready to see. I'm going to lay hands on you. And the revelation is going to come. It's like there's going to be times when you're praying and you're speaking in tongues. And then God says you're going to open the Bible. And then he's going to speak with revelation. There's going to be word within a word within that word. And you're going to say, my God. There's a fresh hunger for revelation, okay? Faith comes by hearing. Revelation comes by seeing. You're coming in. You've done great with faith. But God's going to take you into revelation where you will begin to see the living Christ out of the black and white pages of the Bible. Open your hands up. In this season, I stir also the prophetic anointing and a greater measure of healing in the right hand. You've seen it. You've seen it. You've seen it. You know who Randy Clark is? Randy Clark. Randy Clark laid on top of me, okay, for like 20 to 30 minutes. I know. That's what I was laughing too when he did it. I didn't even know who Randy Clark was, and this was 25 years ago. I'm not kidding. Listen, I've had the hands. I've had, you name it, every prophet in the country has laid hands on me, okay? That you know, the who's who, they've done that. Randy Clark laid his body on me. I'm like, if you kiss me, I swear this Mexican will beat you in syllables, con la chancla. I'm just thinking, you guys know who Randy Clark is? When he got up out of there, I began to operate in miracles and healings from that day forward in a greater dimension. I'm telling you, there's a greater dimension coming with healing. There's going to be such tremendous revelation in communion. Communion is not, most people take it as a ritual. Jesus said, you do this in remembrance of what I did for you. Body was for healing, blood was for forgiveness and for victory, for blessing, for righteousness. But the body in the Old Testament, they would take the unleavened bread, and before they put it in the oven, you know what they did? They pierced it and they would stripe it, not even knowing that Jesus would eventually become the bread of heaven that had to be pierced. He was the unleavened bread, the man without sin who'd be pierced, and by his stripes were healed. The tomb was not a tomb, it was an oven. The kingdom was the leaven. And the leaven was, that's why there was an angel on one side and an angel on the other side. The Ark of the Covenant had an angel and an angel, and God said, hey, Moses, if you want to meet with me, I'll meet with you right there between the faces of the cherubim. That's where the glory is. Romans chapter 6 says, and Jesus Christ rose from the dead by the glory of the Father. So they put Jesus in an oven where one angel was on the head and the other angel at the feet. He put him in the realm of glory. It was the leaven of the kingdom and the glory of the Father that raised Jesus from the dead. And Jesus' resurrection, he's the stand-up and the recovery. That's what resurrection means, the stand-up and the recovery to a better way of life. You're going to get a revelation of that. You'll slap your hands on everything that moves and everything that is sick. It's a new day for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, God will wake you up at 3 a.m. Watch it in the next season. You're going to go look at the wall. You'll look at your phone. It says, say 3:00 a.m. 3:00 a.m. And I will speak to you at 3:00 a.m. I will speak to you and I will cause things to come alive. It was there where you were to take a pen and take some paper. And I will speak to you little hidden nuggets of what you're to do and what you're to say. It's a new day, says the Lord. I give and release that to you in the name of Jesus. Let the impartation now happen. Revelation flow, 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 flow. Okay, now, which one of you guys have digestive problems? You? Esophagus? Digestive? Digestive? Esophagus? Acid reflux? Okay, esophagus. Acid reflux. Acid reflux? Acid reflux? Digestive? Okay, acid reflux? Okay, come over here. Come over here with this. These three and these three. First of all, the devil is a liar. There's nothing you can do to make God love you anymore, unless he loves you, okay? He loves you, okay? In the name of Jesus, I'm just a conduit. In the name of Jesus, I rebuke your sickness, your infirmity, in the name, look at me, in the name of Jesus. By love itself, in the name of Jesus, I speak an adjustment to your sovereign. Ah, korap. In the name of Jesus, don't touch her. The power of God comes and heals your esophagus. And I say to acid reflex, no more. No more. Who's on medication? Anybody on medication? In the name of Jesus, it's a new day for you. In the name of Jesus, valves open and close properly. Yeah. No more waking up in the middle of the night. Throat burning. Put your hands on your digest. Just put your, yeah. Ah, the power of God. There it is. Yeah, let it go. 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 Ah. Oh, that's the power of God, man. Take a deep breath. Just let it go. Rakete, sikete boso. Oh, yeah. No mas. No mas. No more. Yeah. Healed. Healed. In the name. Take a deep breath. Just take a deep breath. Power of God. Power of God. Mend. 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 It's a new day. Did you guys enjoy tonight? Did you guys enjoy tonight? Those of you guys that got the Holy Ghost, I'm telling you, don't listen to that dude over here. Listen to this dude that says, man, keep doing it. Keep doing it. I double dog dare you. You speak in tongues for an hour a day. You become powerful. Then make it 2 hours. Then three. This is what's going to happen. Here, you're going to speak in tongues 5 minutes, and then you're going to be shopping at the mall. What are you laughing at? This is what's going to happen. I'm telling you. I go fishing. Koroboshita, I go fishing. Then I have to, that's your soul. Your soul wanders. Your spirit always wants to pray. Your soul's like, ah, man, I don't, come on. Let's go fishing. Let's go shopping. So you have to stop at that moment and say, soul, submit to my spirit. You're going to pray for an hour. So then you're going to go, katelebosika, and then it's 10 minutes and it wanders. You said, no. Then it's 15 minutes. Then you, no. You got to build capacity. For me, before I wander now, it's like 3 hours. After 3 hours, I start going fishing. It's like, oh, that's my capacity. There are some people who can do longer. That's awesome. But you build a capacity. Can you imagine if our church and your church was praying in tongues? Come on, for 3 hours a day? Come on, dispensing the kingdom, not afraid. We'll turn Tri-Cities upside down. Listen, there's enough people for everybody.